Fall protection is a critical lesson, as falls remain the leading cause of fatalities at construction sites. We will cover how to plan effectively, identify the right equipment, discuss different fall arrest systems, and how to properly operate and inspect safety equipment. We will cover the ABCs of fall protection: guardrails, roof fall protection, and covering holes. Falls account for more than one-third of the total number of fatalities in the construction industry. It forces OSHA to be overly cautious when identifying fall hazards at work sites. This results in fall protection violations being the most frequently cited by OSHA authorities. When working from heights, we must plan projects to ensure each job is done safely. Coming up with a plan beforehand allows you to identify fall protection measures and tools you may need. Southern Air provides our team with fall arrest systems and the right equipment for the job every time they're working 6 or more feet off the ground. It's Southern Air's goal to train you how to recognize the hazards on the job, the proper way to set up fall arrest systems, and the right way to use other safety equipment. According to the National Safety Council, 20% of fall-related fatalities occurred in the victim's first 2 months on the job. That's why it's imperative to Southern Air we train you the right way, right away. Fall protection in construction is required anytime there's an exposure to fall 6 feet or higher. Many of our industrial customers require us to follow the general industry guidelines of 4 feet. Once a situation is identified requiring a fall arrest system, we can utilize the ABCs of fall protection. A is for anchorage points. Anchorage points are secure points of attachment for lifelines, lanyards, and deceleration devices. They should be solid, unmovable objects such as I-beams, capable of supporting a minimum of 5,000 pounds. The anchor devices Southern Air employs consist of beam walkers, cross arm straps, hinged roof anchors, concrete wedge anchors, and the fall wagon. B is for body harnesses. Harnesses should be adjusted to fit each user snugly and inspected prior to use. Inspections should focus on tears, frays, or burns. Those found with deficiencies must be removed from service immediately. Contact our inventory, tools, and equipment shop to swap out the bad device with a good one.
We're good to go, baby.
C is for connector. A connector is anything that brings the anchorage and the harness together. Connectors can be shock-absorbing lanyards or retractables. These devices assist with slowing your speed and reducing the force on your body in the event of a fall. The safest method to prevent falls is guardrails. Guardrails are required anytime there is a fall potential of 6 feet or more. Keep in mind, these are the minimum standards. Falls from the same level or less than 6 feet can seriously injure an individual or worse. If you see a fall risk, just get rid of it. In construction, guardrails are typically built using 2x4s and consist of a top rail, mid rail, and toe boards. Each railing has certain safety requirements that must be met to remain effective. If a guardrail isn't strong enough, it could break, leaving a worker in a bad situation. Top rails should be 39 to 45 inches in height and capable of supporting 200 pounds. Mid rails are exactly what they sound like. These should be right in the middle of the top rails and toe boards and able to support at least 150 pounds. Toe boards are necessary anytime an object could fall from a roof or leading edge. Ask yourself, if I drop a tape measure from the roof, could it hit someone? If the answer is yes, you need a tow board. These are placed at the bottom of the guardrail system and need a minimum height of 3.5 inches with the ability to support 50 pounds. If 2x4s or other pre-assembled guardrails are not available, another method calls for cable. With a minimum diameter of 1/4 inches, cables may be used for the top and mid rails. The cables must have less than 3-inch deflection and use Crosby clamps installed correctly. Cables must also be flagged every 6 feet with a high visibility material. Tow boards should still be made from a 2x4. Handrails are needed when there are at least 4 steps or a change of 30 inches in elevation. A step is required when there is 19 inches or more between 2 surfaces. All steps should be solid, secured, and flat level surface. Holes in the rooftop or floors also present a very real fall hazard. Southern Air uses covers to protect employees from falling through holes when they are present. OSHA defines a hole as 2 or more inches in its least dimension in a floor, roof, or other walking or working surface. Hole covers must support twice the weight of the intended load. Covers need to be secured to prevent them from being accidentally moved, and covers should be clearly marked with the word hole to identify the hazard. When working on flat rooftops with a fall potential of 6 feet or more, you must have a fall protection plan. Anything closer than 15 feet to a roof's edge will require personal fall protection. Work conducted 15 feet or further from a roof's edge can be done safely from behind a warning line system. A warning line system consists of flagging and stanchion posts to identify work areas and walking paths. Warning line needs to be erected on all unprotected sides. For example, a 39-inch tall parapet wall is considered protected, therefore not needing to be flagged. Key takeaways. Falls are the leading cause of fatalities at construction sites. Remember to plan ahead to get the job done safely, provide the right equipment, and train everyone to use the equipment safely. Remember the ABCs of fall protection. They are anchorage points, body harnesses, and connectors. Guardrails are required when there is exposure to falls of 6 feet or more. Guardrails consist of a top rail, a mid rail, and tow boards, all which must be installed correctly to be an effective safety barrier. Holes in the floor 2 inches or larger require a well-marked, properly installed cover capable of withstanding twice the amount of the intended load. Anytime you're working on rooftops, you must have a fall protection plan. Anything closer than 15 feet to a roof's edge will require personal fall protection.